Ham Radio Now, episode 142. This is only a test. And it was going to be a little bit more of a test because I was going to try to upload this directly to YouTube. I thought I could figure out how to do that. I'd seen upload buttons and stuff. And I'm in a hurry. But of course, I couldn't figure out how to do that. So what I'm going to do is record this as a file and upload the file right away. No graphics, no anything else going on. I just wanted to get something online to fill in the gap because it's been a while and it's going to be a while before I get another big production, and I'll explain why. First reason is this thing here is kicking my butt. The Yaesu FTM 400 DVR, whatever it is, and its associated handy talkies. A previous episode, I explained that it was a 200-page instruction manual. This is a very complex and deep radio. I'm happy with a lot of stuff in the radio, and there are a few things that I don't like very much. Attention, QST. Attention, editors. Whatever issue this review is going into, don't plan on anything else. Anything else. Headphones. Don't plan on anything else. This is going to take the whole issue. All right, so what else is going on? Let's see. Oh, I forgot to stick up a website. Let me grab a website quick in real time, rars.org. And RarsFest. This weekend is my local radio club's big HamFest. I'm not putting this on here to suggest that you come. Although if you're in the Raleigh, North Carolina area or reasonable driving distance, it's a good HamFest. It'll draw 1,500 to 2,000 people. So it's not a huge HamFest. It's a nice large. Larger than local, not quite regional HamFest. You know, it's not like a Huntsville or an Orlando, but it's not your little local park flea market thing. So, I've done an episode of Ham Radio Now from the HamFest, episode 9, part 1 and part 2, or 9A and 9B. We're done at this local HamFest. It's got a lot of interesting things going on at it. So if you feel like you need a little bit more ham radio now and you haven't been way back at these early episodes, stop by episode 9 and see the interesting stuff we do. Have you ever seen anybody operating a QLF key? You now try sending with your left foot. How about a QBH machine? Sending Morse code with your hips. Should be wearing a grass skirt for that. And there's also something, oops, wrong button, something else interesting in this episode that I don't think anybody else has ever covered in ham radio before. I call the episode Before You Die. And this fella here, Chuck Littlewood, K4HF, he's a real spark plug of the club. He's the only guy left from the original crew that formed the radio club back in the mid-70s sometime. It was formed from the ashes of a previous radio club. He's the original founding member, only guy left. In fact, we have sort of a saying in this radio club, and this may apply to other radio clubs too, I don't know. If you want to get rid of somebody in the club, elect them president. Most of the past presidents of the past two decades, the time I've been there, like 24 years, most of the past presidents are no longer active in the club. I was president in 98, 99, and I stayed active for another decade or so, and I'm still active. I don't go to the board meetings, I go to the club meetings, and I'm still participating, but this Ham Radio Now thing is using up pretty much all my time. This Yaesu Radio. So, but this weekend will be the HamFest, and so I've been busy doing that. My job this year was to design the program. I've sort of been the graphics guy for the radio club. So I designed and output the program, and I'm going to head over to Kinko's this afternoon and pick it up and deliver it to the folks who are getting stuff set up. And then I have to bake my traditional chocolate chip cookies from my secret recipe. They're the best chocolate chip cookies anyone's ever had. It wins the awards. Well, they don't give the awards anymore. They gave an award one year for the best baked goods or something at the was a club meeting or a ham fest. It was a long time ago. I won. Very secret recipe. Don't tell anybody. But I got to finish those off today. Get them over there tomorrow. The ham fest is on Saturday. This is Thursday as I'm recording this. So there's lots of stuff to do. And in the meantime, still learning more and then writing up this this review of the ASU radio. What else? I got email from somebody. There's a better way to look at the email. There we go. From WB8NUT from Duffy. Gary, please don't take this the wrong way. I was pretty disappointed in your or with your CQ interview. The reason is it doesn't answer any real questions related to production problems. And there was a fairly popular episode. I think just about everybody watching now saw my interview with Rich Moses and W2VU, the editor of CQ. And they've been having problems, and they're continuing to have problems. Let's see. What else? In other words, what are the production problems? Did the presses break? Did they change printers? Are the new guys not working out? Or as I believe, not me, but Duffy, they have run out of money. They're looking maybe looking for financing, unable to get it to pay the printer and keep the magazine going out. And I'm going to say that all speculation, because no, I didn't ask Rich what exactly are the problems. I started the interview with Rich, what the heck? And I didn't expect him to get into detail with me. Really don't expect him to get into detail with me about what the problems were there. He tiptoed around the issues by saying that things like CQVHF and Popular Communications and World Radio Online were not pulling their weight, and they were pulling down CQ Magazine, which is why they integrated everything together. Now, you have to read between the lines, and I wasn't doing a 60 minutes interview, and I wasn't trying to beat the poor guy to death. I could have said, Rich, what are the problems there? And maybe I should have. Again, this is not an investigative report. This was a conversation, pretty much a real-time conversation. But if you read between the lines, he was pretty much saying, yeah, we don't have the money to do these things anymore. And my interpretation of that, a lot of other hams, comments on the QRZ from, on various posts and threads that deal with the CQ issue are that they've got money problems. They're not able to pay the printer or the postage or both, and they're just barely squeaking it out. And I hope they solve those problems, and I don't know whether they will or not. Let me go a little bit deeper here into Duffy's email. I like the magazine. I have almost 2 years of subscription remaining, but I, like many hams, have run out of patience. The February issue was supposed to follow the January issue soon. Then the March-April issue was supposed to go out in early April, and they would be back on schedule. Now, the February issue was canceled and became a digital-only issue, and I frankly had not seen that, but it is true. And let's go back to here on the CQ website. We're still experiencing delays with the print editions. In an effort to get these problems resolved once and for all, and I hope it's once and for all, you know, this could be really once and for all, or it could be just kind of, again, dancing around the issue. We have taken the following action. CQ's February issue will be a digital-only issue available as PDF via the cover picture shown below, so everybody can download it if you want to. Simply click on the cover and download it. Since this will not be available as a print edition, it will not be counted as an issue in any print subscription term. So the mail delivery of the March-April issue is scheduled for mid-April. As I record this, it is April 17th, so we're a little bit past mid-April. I'm not sure I'm going to get a print copy or not. My subscription was theoretically going to be up around March or so, with things being consolidated that in theory got extended from my print subscription. I made a separate and new digital subscription, and it's been a little difficult to tell what the subscription status is at CQ. And I haven't gone online or on the phone to bug them about what's going on. I care, but I don't care that much, I guess. So let's see. These actions will put our monthly print edition delivery back on track. We would like to take this opportunity to thank our loyal subscribers, et cetera, et cetera. And the contest information will be coming out. So CQ is a really valuable resource, not just for the magazine, but for all the contests and other stuff that they do. So I hope they are able to continue one way or another. For me, if it just becomes an online deal and they can't afford to do print and postage, that would be fine. I prefer to receive my magazines online. In fact, I've got, crank up Vimeo here. Vimeo is their, it's interesting. The Vimeo application is not showing up on my screen. I've seen that in a few cases. This is Wirecast taking the picture directly, taking the screen directly. And this is my camera showing over the shoulder. So it's not showing up for some reason. Again, I've seen that in a few cases with Chrome. It's weird. I don't know what the deal is with Vimeo. It's trying to give me, looks like, free magazines. This ink and Shutterbug, and I don't know what those things are. But there's the April issue of, the combined March-April issue of CQ. And I've had that for a while. You know, that came in a while ago. So it is here, and the May issue should be coming out, you know, sometime. Not too far. Their issue, their cover date. Most magazines do their cover date sometime in the weeks before the month of the cover date. CQ has typically been more in that month, and with the print edition anyway, end of that month, sort of toward the next month in a lot of cases. So like I say, I really would like to see them survive, even for me, if it's just print. But I know a lot of you get really upset if it's just digital. A lot of you would get upset if it was just digital. You're hanging on to the old print stuff. You know, I read stuff on my tablet, my Nexus 7, which is not sitting in arm's reach where I'd grab it and show it to you. I can take that to the library. Okay, the bathroom. I can take it to the bathroom. It's just fine. Let's see. What else does Duffy say? Let me find the rest of his email. I think what we are about to learn is that they have been unable to get financing, and the entire thing will be announced in early May. What did I miss here? Oh, they think they're going to fold. So he would like me to revisit CQ with an interview, ask him why they keep missing commitments, and what the mysterious production problems was. He says he exchanged some emails with Katie, their new advertising person, who I believe will have a very short career there. And she would not or could not go into specifics. When I hammered her for some answers, she said something like that they don't think CQ needs to talk to the public about business issues. So thinks the whole thing is financial. Scrambling to get some soon. Not getting it. Prediction they are going to fold. Some other people who have opinions and knowledge that I respect in the ham radio business are also thinking that. So I will drop Rich a line and offer him the opportunity to come back on the program. They've always, of course, got their own website and plenty of avenues to talk to you directly. But conversations are good, and I'll offer him the opportunity to do that. And we'll see if he takes me up on it. So that's the end of this experiment in internet broadcasting. No graphics, no music, no clone at the end of the episode. I will just say thanks for watching 73. Visit Arvin. This is not a financial decision. It's purely time. It's about 10 minutes to 11 in the morning, and I've got to get moving and will not have any time through the weekend with a ham fest and all to produce an episode. So I wanted to get something up here. It'll just be on YouTube. I'm probably not going to even advertise it anyplace. So if you're watching this and you want to tell other people about it, put a note up on QRZ. Oh, I guess I should make some kind of mention about the shirts. Yeah, always in the promotional mode. Let me get the computer back to where it's pointing to the right stuff. Get back here. There we go. Dress for success. When I talked to Tom when we did the episode, he was just doing the t-shirts for Ham Radio Now. He has decided to go ahead and add the hoodies and the sweatshirts so you can get all of that stuff. And even QRZ got in on the act, and they put a note. I didn't put anything on QRZ. This is purely promotional to me. I don't want to use QRZ as an advertising conduit, since I'm not paying them to advertise. I'll, you know, an information conduit to let you people know there's an episode up and make me and let me give a chance to say a few things about the episode. But and I'm glad they let me do that. But they put their own up. They put their own notice up. Let's look at QRZ.com. Let me dig that up. QRZ. Where did they say it? Yeah. I mean, they were mostly talking about their own shirts, but they mentioned the episode and that you could get on there. And the only thing I want to say about that is that some guy had to say, there we go, $20 for a t-shirt? Come on, come on. Easy, easy there. Easy, big fella. $20 for a t-shirt? Let me make that bigger. You deserve to see this. I don't think so. Back to Walmart, fella. 73. I'm Gary Pierce, KN4AQ. Over and out. I gotta click this button. Stop the stream.